Let's say we've got two countries, country A and country B. And at the start of our little hypothetical thought experiment, they have a very stable exchange rate. Maybe it's one for one. Every A, if you were to go into foreign currency markets, you could get a B for it. So there's kind of this stable supply and demand between these two currencies. Now let's say for whatever reason, folks in A start to believe that B, country B, is the hot place to invest. They want to buy country B's real estate. They want to invest in country B's stock market. And so if they want to buy stuff in B, they essentially have to hold more of B's currency. And so more and more people in A want to exchange their A's for country B's currency. So you have this huge supply of A's coming onto the foreign exchange markets, but you still have the same amount of B's that want to go the other way. Maybe, and you know, these are maybe there to either invest in country A or maybe buy some of country A's exports or whatever it might be. But if we just let this happen on its own, where all of a sudden there's a much larger demand for converting A's into B than converting B's into A, you'll have a situation where the B's will just get more expensive. There's more demand for B's than they are for A's. They'll get more expensive in terms of A's. So if you look at it from country A's point of view, you're now having to pay more A's per B. And a completely equivalent statement from country B's perspective, you would now have to pay fewer B's per A. Now, let's say for whatever reason, you are the central bank. You are the central bank right over here of country B. And you don't like your currency becoming stronger. Maybe you just don't like the volatility in the exchange markets. You don't like the idea that the exchange rates go up and down so dramatically. Maybe you just don't want your exports to get expensive or that imports from another country to get cheap. For whatever reason, you do not like this movement happening. And so what you're going to do is, because you have the right to do it, you are the central bank of your country, you can print more of your currency right here, the currency B's. So you're going to print more of these. So you could print more of them, just like that. And then you can use that extra B that you just printed to buy more A's. And so now you've kind of renormalized the supply and the demand for B's. But what's going to be the end product of that? Well, you did successfully keep your currency from appreciating relative to the A's, which based on how this was all set up, that was your goal. But the other thing that you ended up with is since you printed B's and you're able to buy A's in the open market, you now on your balance sheet, or maybe in your vaults, you have a bunch of A's. And so when people talk about foreign currency reserves, let me write it down, foreign currency reserves, and pretty much every central bank has foreign currency reserves. This is what they're talking about. That central bank printed their own currency and went out into currency foreign exchange markets and bought other countries' currencies. And there's multiple reasons for them doing it. This might be one of them, or it might be to protect them in the case that this whole dynamic reverses in the other direction, especially if it reverses in a very dramatic way.